Today, one thing very positive, and I was telling Pawan, is that you have a wider, representative, having a pharma company like Centis here, med devices company and healthcare providers. So this is the kind of gathering that we should have and try and create a SRO concept to approach the government. So that's on the challenge side. Now on the opportunity side. Clearly, you know, just to give you an example, when this whole stent price capping happened, there were a few hospitals in our portfolio which didn't bear the brunt of the price cap. Why? Because they followed a very simple rule right from day one. Their markup was 10% over the purchase price. So we didn't get dented on the margins. So it's about how you approach the provision of a services. That is one important element. The second is, you know, how do you bring all the stakeholders together right from day one? You know, how do you do your clinical engagement program, which is very, very important, because if you see the margin benefit that we get on the consumables, pharma, and on the diagnostic goes to subsidize what we lose on the services side. So how do you approach the entire provision of services from a supply side, you know, the engagement of all the components? That is very, very critical. Having said that, you know, the prices that we have in today's regime is still not profitable for even a tier two hospital. So there are challenges on that side. And, you know, our view as an investor is that we as a industry player should get together, you know, on an SRO concept and try to table the issues to the government. It may be late in the day, but I guess, you know, we have no other option. And when I say as a stakeholder, means all the components, but, you know, the pharma suppliers, the diagnostic you know, suppliers and vendors, the clinicians, you know, who are very, very important part of the equation. All of us should get together as one industry body, because, you know, most of the time that we've seen, you know, it's either the healthcare providers who are making the representation or the pharma or the med devices making the representations. Today, one thing very positive, and I was telling Pawan, is that you have a wider representative, having a pharma company like Centis here, med devices company and healthcare providers. So this is the kind of gathering that we should have and try and create a SRO concept to approach the government. So that's on the challenge side. Now on the opportunity side, you know, we see huge amount of opportunity, and these opportunities come for us in two ways. One is supply chain disruptors, because now the industry players are forced to cut down the cost. They will have to go in each and every component of the value chain and see where they can save cost. And world over, there is significant amount of wastage in the entire value chain. And obviously it's led by US, where, you know, there is no formula to fix. But in a country like India, there are significant opportunities. If we start breaking down the value chain, and here I see a couple of players, you know, who are prime example. You know, we have a company like Medica Bazaar, which is now providing direct consumables to hospitals in tier two, tier three, tier four cities. We have a player like Shubham, who's now saying that, you know, you outsource all the non-clinical part to a player who knows best. You get quality, you get that, you get price benefit. Now, if you start breaking the entire value chain, there is significant amount of costing. And that is an opportunity for investors like us. There are models which are access accelerators. You know, 40% of the population in India don't have provision of healthcare. Now, if you back models, and there are quite a few of them, you know, the basic one is telemedicine, which is still struggling, but there are quite ample number of opportunities. If you back those kind of players, encourage them, you know, through industry participation, through investor backing, the load on the tertiary care will go down. There are multiple ways in which, you know, one would benefit. If you focus on primary care, the load, the patient, because our clinical pathway is a bit distorted. Even for cough and cold, we end up in a multi-speciality hospital. So if you start focusing just on these two aspects, which is the value chain disruptors and the access accelerators, I think the costing will settle down to a reasonable level. Not sure if you'll still make money with, you know, the Ayushman Bharat players, but at least it's a good starting point for us.